On the 6th of April, we venerate St. Crescentia Hess, a contemplative nun of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis. Crescentia was born on October 20th, 1682, in a little town in the Diocese of Augsburg. Her father, Matthias Hess, a simple weaver, was barely able, in spite of diligent work, to provide the necessaries for his family of 8 children. But he was a pious Christian, satisfied with his condition, and delighted to think upon the poor life and the bitter suffering of Jesus Christ. The mother bore a tender love for the sick and poor. Crescentia received the virtues of her good parents as a precious inheritance. Even as a child, she would withdraw from association with her playmates in order to pray in church or in a quiet corner of the house. If a poor person came to the house at mealtime, she often asked permission to give her portion to him. At an early age, St. Crescentia Hess was so thoroughly instructed in the truths of religion that her spiritual director permitted her to go to Holy Communion at the tender age of 7. Her answers in catechism class were sometimes filled with such depth of meaning that she said, "My child, you must surely have a higher teacher." It has been recorded that her guardian angel and the Lord himself, in the guise of a child, frequently conversed with her. As Crescentia grew older, she not only assisted her mother in all the housework, but also learned weaving from her father, in spite of the fact that she was not robust. Her whole deportment, however, showed that she was not destined for this world. In town, she was called the Little Angel, and she entertained no fonder hope than to be admitted among the consecrated virgins in the convent of the Tertiaries in her native town. But the convent was poor, and the superiors declared that they could not receive her without a dowry. Then the Protestant mayor of the town lent his aid. He had rendered the convent a great service when the nuns came to offer their expressions of gratitude. He told them that they might now, as a favor to him, accept the daughter of the poor weaver Hess. It would surely be a shame, he added, if such an angel were spoiled by the world. Now Crescentia was received into the convent, but she was made to feel that she had come without a dowry, and was received only through force of necessity. She was compelled to do the lowliest work of a maid. She was regarded as a burden, frowned upon, and despised. Her readiness to be obliging and friendly were set down as flattery and hypocrisy, and when visible persecutions came from the devil, she was called a witch. The nuns would gladly have gotten rid of her if they had not been obliged to consider the mayor. In spite of all these things, St. Crescentia Hess remained steadfast in her vocation. When the evil enemy said to her, "Go home, there you will not have it so bad as here," she said in answer, "I am ready to suffer still worse things." Often St. Crescentia Hess said that she was only a poor weaver's daughter who was received out of pity and should consequently not be permitted to make demands. Nevertheless, after 4 years, conditions improved. A new superior soon recognized the eminent virtue of Sister Crescentia. She was appointed portress and later on novice mistress, in which position she won the love and respect of all the sisters to such a degree that after the death of the superior, she was unanimously elected as the successor. As a superior, St. Crescentia Hess evinced not only maternal affection for her sisters and holy zeal for their spiritual advancement, but also such prudence in material affairs that the circumstances of the convent became better than they had ever been. Meanwhile, she was entirely devoted to the interior life. God Almighty granted her very special enlightenment, so that her advice was constantly sought. Not only did the people come from all parts of Swabia, but princes and princesses, as well as bishops and even 2 cardinals, came or wrote to her to ask for her advice and opinion in most weighty matters. Crescentia, like a true daughter of St. Francis, always remained a model of humility. In her final sufferings, her virtue was to be specially tried. From the very beginning of her convent life, she had been much afflicted with headaches and toothaches. Added to this, she was later attacked with severe pains in the side, so that she could not walk a step. As the years advanced, bodily sufferings increased. She lay so severely ill that her hands and feet were entirely crippled and her whole body rolled up like a ball. To this was added severe pain in the back. But remembering the sufferings of Christ, in which she wished to share, she cried out, "O ye bodily members, praise God that He has given you the capacity to suffer." Finally, perfected in the way of sanctity, St. Crescentia Hess went to the joys of her Lord on Easter Sunday, April 9, 1744. Her virtues were pronounced heroic as early as 1801. She was beatified by Pope Leo XIII in the Jubilee year 1900. Placing all our petitions before her today, let us pray the prayer of love to God written by St. Crescentia herself. Grant, O God, that love and suffering may grow hand in hand in me, so that I may love you more and more with the cheerful disposition which is the fruit of love. O Lord, only grant me love for you, and I shall be rich enough. I desire only that you leave me to my nothingness, and that you alone, if I may say so, be all in all, and loved and honored by everybody. I wish to take pleasure in nothing but only in you and your love. Amen.